In this training video, I'm going to cover some additional tips and tricks that is aimed at helping technical divers who want to dive with multiple stage cylinders. The first thing to understand is that all divers who want to use multiple stage cylinders have to be efficient using two cylinders, then three cylinders, and have very good buoyancy control and awareness. But even then, three cylinders, I tend to think, is the limit that somebody would want to swim. When you start considering diving with four cylinders or even five cylinders, you want to think about using a DPV to actually move you through the water, as swimming just does not become that efficient due to the increased equipment load you're carrying. Having said that, the more streamlined your configuration is, and the fact that if you set your cylinders up, as I'm showing you, your stages will hold in position no matter what orientation you're in. This will give you the best chance at efficiency as you swim and move through the water. One big advantage to Sidemount is that it offers great hydrodynamics as you move through the water, as the cylinders are under your arms. The stages will not trim themselves though, so make sure you keep correct tension on your lower cylinder bungees. If you're moving around a lot, then it is possible this will slacken off a little bit. It only takes a few seconds to check during the dive, so there really is no excuse for not having your stage cylinders trimmed correctly. They should look like the example you're seeing right now, and it's great to do a helicopter turn and have somebody video it so you can check. It's likely that you're diving trimix with four or more cylinders, so I advise you to use a Drysuit inflation cylinder and it be butt mounted like you see here. I have a full complete training video covering how to mount a Drysuit inflation cylinder with different options, so make sure you check that out. If you're using four cylinders, the additional weight of those first stages will affect your trim, especially if you're diving in a wetsuit. By doing a diver trim checking exercise, you can see what effect that has on your overall trim. In this example, I'm fairly well balanced from head to toe. As you can see, I'm not really tipping forwards or backwards. I'm kind of just hanging there in suspense. This is the right ideal trim to have. In this example, I had a brand new wetsuit and boots, and you can see it's quite a different effect. My legs are definitely more buoyant. This results in the diver's trim being top heavy. One of the things I can do to help is move my weighting lower down. What I can't do is add additional weight that I don't need. It's really important that you understand you can only work with what you need. You should never add additional weight. It can be a little frustrating using multiple stage cylinders in a wetsuit, as it just doesn't have the lift near the top of the shoulders, which is why some Sidemount BCDs work better than others for lifting higher up the body. However, a dry suit is probably the best thing you can use to balance out your whole body, because you can control the way the air migrates around the suit, trapping a little more air in the top of the shoulders and arms when needed to correct trim. And it's actually very likely you use a dry suit when using four or more cylinders, as you're probably spending a lot of time underwater and need the thermal exposure for dives of that duration. What you'll find great about my side mount setup and stage cylinder setup is that your BCD and dry suit inflators remain totally accessible, not only to use them, but also if you need to disconnect the hose in an emergency. It's very important that your stage cylinders actually sit underneath your side mount cylinders. This obviously gives you good access to the stage cylinders, but you'll also find that it does not interfere with accessing any of your core side mount configuration, which is very important. In fact, every piece of equipment needs to remain accessible, and that includes your side mount pouch and anything you have clipped to the butt D-ring, like your reels, an SMB for example. What I sometimes find using a dry suit and multiple stage is that I accidentally lose air from the shoulder valve on the dry suit due to my trim with multiple stage. So I've found a good trick is not to have the dry suit valve fully open and instead close it by a third. It's important that none of your core skills are affected either. These are skills like handing off your long hose in an out of air emergency. You see, it's no good if you add a stage cylinder and you can no longer deploy the hose correctly, or that stage cylinder blocks access to your low pressure inflator, making it difficult to add air to the BCD or your dry suit. To become efficient using stage cylinders, it's something you have to practice frequently. The skills will diminish over time. And there really is no substitute for time spent in the water. I would say most people have problems with cylinder donning and doffing as opposed to cylinder switching, but it's important you practice both equally. One of the things that can be good to practice is clipping the stages to your butt D-ring via the top clip and the base sits up. This can be useful when you've finished a decompression stop and you've got some surface support either on a boat or shore, and then you just easily unclip from the butt, passing one cylinder at a time.